Dear friends, welcome to my channel. Before going to the video, please do not forget to subscribe my channel and click bell icon left to the subscribe button for latest updates. Friends, today we discuss the topic techniques and facts about sex life in ancient Egypt. Sex has become too central in this modern day society, or so the conservatives have thought. What not a lot of people realize is that sex is even more bizarre in the ancient times than today's standards. Just when everyone thought the ancient Romans and Greeks have weird sex practices, the ancient Egyptians brought a big revelation on how kinky they can get when it comes to carnal pleasures. Sex for the ancient Egyptians seemed to have no limits. But that's not to say that they can do whatever they want just to achieve that pleasure. They may not engage in orgies, but we are talking about necrophilia, bestiality, and incest. Here, taboo practices that are considered a thing in the ancient civilization. Here are 10 surprising sex facts about ancient Egypt you need to know. Number 1. Necrophilia was actually a thing. We all know about Egyptians and their respect for the dead and belief in mummification. But it turns out that there is not much respect going on with corpses. Reports have it that embalmers take advantage of the dead and have sex with them, especially if the dead bodies belong to a beautiful woman. Fortunately, this taboo act is considered inappropriate, that anyone caught doing it will be denounced. Some have claimed that men would keep their dead wives for a few days before having them embalmed. Number 2. Egyptians had a lot of sex with animals, even crocodiles. If necrophilia was acceptable for some, so was bestiality, or sex with the animals. You may have heard about sex with horses and even dogs, but with ancient Egyptian sex with animals goes beyond those mammals. Even reptiles can be used for carnal purposes. Egyptians believe in shapeshifters, like how the god and goddesses would take on different forms of animals. Apparently, this belief led the Egyptians to accept that sex with any four-legged animal is acceptable. There were reports of a person having sex with cows or apes, but the most dangerous that have been reported was sex with a crocodile. One would wonder how that could even be possible. Number 3. The Cleopatra rumors. If there is one famous ancient Egypt personality who is no stranger to sex, that would be Cleopatra. She hooked up with Julius Caesar and Mark Antony. And if she has no one to toy with, she would entertain herself with a vibrator, a box filled with bees. Ew, clever. Number 4. Seth and Horus, the divine gay couple. Eyes here for Seth and Horus, odd story. You must probably know about how the gods and goddesses like to have sex with anyone or everyone. Trick others and fight each other, right? For Egyptian gods Seth and Horus, the sexual tension was always there. Eventually, Seth did the dirty deed with Horus to show him who's the boss. But Seth wasn't able to penetrate Horus because Horus Mother Isis got in the way. If she hadn't, Horus would have been avoided by other gods because he got into the submissive position. So the story went how Horus caught Seth's semen and spread it into the river. Isis then got Horus' semen and spread it over the lettuce, which she fed to Seth. Ultimately, the gods decided that Seth was the submissive one and looked down on him. Number 5. Acacia gum and dung served as birth control. Birth control was also a thing back in the day, and some Egyptians just don't want to welcome an offspring into the world. Ancient papyrus writings indicated that the sap from the acacia tree and gum were used to kill sperm. Number 6. Egyptian gods and goddesses loved incest. Ancient Egyptians don't usually practice incest, but the same thing cannot be said of the gods and goddesses. This doesn't come out as surprising since we have all heard about how Greek gods Zeus and Hera were related, but they bore their sons Ares and Hephaestus. In some version of the story, this royal breed just have to do it to the preserve their mighty lineage. Number 7. Cheating was punishable. At least the Egyptians view cheating as inappropriate and unacceptable. Unlike a lot of people nowadays, premarital sex was fine, but cheating on your spouse was definitely a no-no. Cheating is even punishable. If a man gets caught fooling around with a married woman other than his wife, punishment could include mutilation, whipping, or even execution. Number 8. Virginity. What's that? Ancient Egyptians didn't care much about virginity. So, if a man married a virgin, it wasn't a big deal. Being a virgin didn't hold any significance in any way. The same thing cannot be said for Romans though. Number 9. The papyrus pon. Erotic images existed in ancient Egypt, but the people weren't that liberal in that aspect. A famous papyrus pon was the Turin erotic papyrus, which measured 8.5 feet long. It contains images of a man having sex with a woman, including on different places like a chariot. Number 10. The masturbation myth. The divine origins had that humans came from Adam and Eve, while Greeks started out from gods giving birth to other divine beings. For Egyptians, there is nothing of that sort. According to the myth, the sun god Ra came out from nothing. In one account, he spat two gods who later gave birth to other divine beings. In another account, Ra masturbated and then the gods came out. Thanks for watching my video. Please like and share my video and subscribe my channel. Comment me below for any suggestions or improvements. Thank you.